What happened to Donovan?
Donovan Leach was born in Maryhill, Glasgow on May 10, 1946 to Donald and Winifred Leach. His grandmothers were born from Ireland. As a child, he contracted polio. He developed a limp as a result of the sickness and treatment. His family relocated to Hatfield in Hertfordshire, England. He began playing the guitar at the age of 14 after being influenced by his family's love of folk music. He enrolled in art school but dropped out after a few months to pursue his beatnik dreams by hitting the road. Peter Eden and Jeff Stevens of Pi Records in London offered Donovan a management and publishing deal. He recorded a 10-track demo tape which included the original of his first song, Catch the Wind, as well as Josie, which was eventually released on iTunes several decades later. The influence of Woody Guthrie and Ramblin' Jack Elliott, who had also impacted Bob Dylan, was evident in the first song. When Billboard reported on an expected production deal between Klein, Most, and Donovan in December 1965, Donovan's meteoric rise came to a halt. Donovan lost his Dylan/Guthrie inspiration by 1966 and was one of the first British pop performers to embrace flower power. He went on to tour in the United States and appeared on Pete Seeger's TV show Rainbow Quest. He developed his connection with Paul McCartney after returning to London and contributed Sky of Blue and Sea of Green to the song Yellow Submarine. In May of 1967, Donovan and Most recorded Sunshine Superman at CBS Studios in Los Angeles. Jazz, American West Coast psychedelia, and folk rock, mainly the Byrds, all had an increasing effect on the record. The Swinging the Fat Angel, which Donovan's book says was written for Cass Elliot, the Mamas and the Papas, is one of the album's highlights. Burst Blues, a homage to Burt Jantz, Guinevere, and Legend of a Girl Child Linda are among the other tracks. Sunshine Superman was a compilation of tunes from Donovan's Sunshine Superman album and Mellow Yellow albums released in the United States. Sean Phillips, an American folk rock singer, plays the sitar on the album. Phillips was a quiet collaborator in the creation of many of Donovan's compositions at the time. Phillips wrote the majority of Season of the Witch, according to Donovan. Donovan made history as the first high-profile British music star to be arrested for marijuana possession. His drug use was primarily limited to cannabis, with a few instances of LSD and mescaline thrown in for good measure. Donovan was one of the Beatles' guests at Abbey Road Studios on February 9, 1967, for the orchestral overdub for A Day in the Life, the finale of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. There Is a Mountain, Donovan's first solo album, was released in 1967 and served as the inspiration for the Allman Brothers Band's Mountain Jam. A Gift from a Flower to a Garden, Donovan's fifth album, was released later that year. It was just the third pop rock double album to be released and was the first rock music box set. The psychedelic and mystical themes were clear. The front cover featured an infrared shot by Carl Ferris of Donovan in a robe clutching flowers and peacock feathers at Bodiam Castle. In May 1968, Donovan recorded Hurdy Gurdy Man. Although the song was written for Mac McLeod, Donovan chose to record it himself. It went on to become one of Donovan's most popular songs, reaching the top 5 in the UK and the US. He was part of the group that visited Maharishi Mahesh Yogi's ashram in early 1968. Donovan's debut UK single Atlantis was released in November 1969 and reached number 23 in the UK with I Love My Shirt as the B-side. Martin Scorsese's 1990 film Goodfellas used the peaceful Calypso-style tune as the backdrop to a brutal incident. It was revived in 2000 for the episode The Deep South of Futurama, which featured a parody rendition of the song depicting the lost city of Atlanta. Epic and Pi released Donovan's Greatest Hits in March 1969. It went to number 4 in the US, sold a million copies, and spent more than a year on the Billboard album chart. The music Bear Babjigal Love Is Hot was published on June 26, 1969, and it won him a following on the rave scene decades later. Donovan took the stage during the first show of the second season of Hyde Park's Free Rock Concerts. Most and Donovan did not work together again until Cosmic Wheels, when Donovan stated that he wanted to record with someone else in 1973. Following the split, Donovan spent 2 months as a member of the rock trio Open Road, creating and recording the album Open Road. Donovan coined the term Celtic rock after reducing the sound of most heavy studio productions to something that could be played by a live band. The album reached number 16 in the US, the third highest of all of his full-length releases to date. But his financial popularity began to dwindle as his concert performances became less frequent and new performers and kinds of popular music emerged. The intention for Open Road was for Don to travel around the world for a year, starting with a boat trip across the Aegean Sea, which was portrayed in the 1970 film There Is an Ocean. This was partly due to his management's advice to go into tax exile, during which he was not to set foot in the UK until April 1971, but he cut the tour short after touring France, Italy, Russia, and Japan. He wrote for the 1972 film The Pied Piper, in which he played the titular character, and for Brother Sun, Sister Moon, during an 18-month tax exile in Ireland from 1971 to 1972. In 1974, Donovan received a publishing windfall when the title song from the Zeffirelli film was covered as the B-side of the million-selling U.S. top 5 hit, The Lord's Prayer, by Australia's singing nun, Sister Janet Mead. Donovan rejoined Mickey Most in early 1973 after signing a new deal with Epic, resulting in the album Cosmic Wheels, which featured arrangements by Chris Spedding. It was his final chart success, hitting the top 40 in both the United States and the United Kingdom. Later in the year, he released Essence to Essence, a live album recorded in Japan and exclusively available in Japan, which includes an extended rendition of Hurdy Gurdy Man with an additional lyric written by George Harrison. Donovan was approached to share lead vocals on Alice Cooper's song Billion Dollar Babies when the album was being recorded. Cosmic Wheels was followed by two albums the following year, Live in Japan Spring Tour 1973, his second concert album, and the more introspective Essence to Essence. Seven Teas from 1974 and Slow Down World from 1975 were his last two Epic Records releases. Following the release of Going for the One in 1977, he opened for Yes on a six-month tour of North America and Europe in 1977. Donovan released in 1978 on Most Rack Records in the UK, and Clive Davis's new Arista Records in the US reunited him with Most and Cameron for the final time, although it was not well received at the height of the new wave and failed to chart. In the 1980s, he released the albums Neutronica from 1980, Love Is Only Feeling from 1981, and Lady of the Stars from 1984, as well as guest starring on CTV's Stars on Ice, a half-hour ice variety show. He took a break when he performed in the Amnesty International benefit event from the Secret Policeman's Other Ball, alongside Sting, Bill Collins, Bob Geldof, Eric Clapton, and Jeff Beck. Donovan performed several successes with Danny Thompson, including Sunshine Superman, Mellow Yellow, Colors, Universal Soldier, and Catch the Wind. He also appeared in the show's conclusion rendition of Bob Dylan's I Shall Be Released. On June 18, 1989, Donovan performed at the Glastonbury Festival, accompanied by the band Osric Tentacles. Donovan released a live album in 1990, which featured new renditions of his classic classics. In 1991, Network published Island of Circles, a tribute album to Donovan. The 1992 publication of Sony's 2-CD box set Troubadour, the Definitive Collection 1964-1976, continued the rehabilitation of his reputation and was followed by the 1994 release of Four Donovan Originals, which featured his four legendary Epic LPs on CD for the first time in its original form in the UK. Rick Rubin, the rap producer and owner of the Def Jam label, became an ally, and he recorded Sutras for Rubin's American Recordings label. On April 16, 2000, Donovan narrated and acted in the Futurama episode The Deep South, which featured a parody of the song Atlantis. Beat Cafe, released in 2004 on Appleseed Records, was a return to the jazzy tone of his 1960s records, with bassist Danny Thompson and drummer Jim Keltner, and was produced by John Chalew of Blind Boys of Alabama. Richard Barone from the Bongos joined Donovan for a series of Beat Cafe concerts in New York, singing and reading portions from Allen Ginsberg's Howl. Donovan sang Sunshine Superman during the Crown Prince and Crown Princess of Denmark's wedding concert in May 2004. On iTunes, he published 64, his early demo tapes, and a re-recording of the Brother Sun, Sister Moon soundtrack. On May 9, 2005, a box set of his Mickey Most albums was published. Extra tracks are included in this EMI package, including a tune recorded with the Jeff Beck Group. His autobiography, The Hurdy-Gurdy Man, was published in 2005. Donovan performed for two nights at Camden's The Jazz Cafe in London in the spring and summer of 2006. Donovan performed at the Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C., Alice Tully Hall in New York City, and the Kodak Theater in Los Angeles in January 2007, in conjunction with a filmmaker David Lynch event promoting the David Lynch Foundation for Consciousness-Based Education and World Peace. Raven Productions videotaped the concert at the Kodak Theater and presented it as a pledge drive on public television. Donovan's collaboration with the David Lynch Foundation saw him conduct concerts and give talks about meditation from September to October of 2000. In May 2000, he spoke at the Maharishi University of Management in Fairfield, Iowa. In October 2007, he toured the United Kingdom with David Lynch. Donovan did a three-part series on Ravi Shankar for BBC Radio 2 in April 2007. Donovan unveiled plans for the Invincible Donovan University in October 2007, which will focus on transcendental meditation. It will be in the vicinity of Glasgow or Edinburgh. The Donovan's concert, live in LA, filmed at the Kodak Theater in Los Angeles earlier that year, was released in the UK in October 2007. Donovan was named a BMI icon at the 2009 annual BMI London Awards on October 6, 2009. BMI composers who have had a unique and indelible influence on generations of music makers are designated as icons. Donovan's double CD set, Ritual Groove, was released in October 2010 through his website. He defined it as a multimedia album awaiting the addition of videos before its publication. Donovan released his new song, I'm the Shaman, on his 75th birthday on May 10th of 2021. David Lynch, who also directed the accompanying video, produced this song. And he also released On Christmas Day, which came out December 15th of 2021. And that's what happened to Donovan. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe if you haven't already. And if you click that playlist on screen, it'll show you some of my favorite Donovan songs. It'll take you on a trip through memory lane. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.